Hello viewers, in our previous video we have seen the formation of covalent bond. Now in this video we are going to see the 4.2 topic, that is the versatile nature of the carbon. So carbon possessing this kind of versatile nature because of the two unique properties possessed by the carbon atom that we are going to discuss over here. So let's start with the first property. First property is the catenation property. Now the catenation property means what? That the carbon can make bond with other carbon atom and form long chain, branched chain and cyclic chain. This unique property of the carbon is called catenation property because carbon is able to form bond with other carbon atom, and by this way it can able to form long chain, branched chain, even cyclic chain. Long chain means there is a number of carbon atom bonded with each other and forming a large or a long chain. Similar way, the number of carbon atom bonded with each other in a branched form, like this way, right, as you can see in the example. So because of this unique catenation property, it is versatile. Now see, some of the other element also showing this kind of catenation property, but up to certain extent only. If you are going to talk about the silicon, then silicon can form a compound with hydrogen up to 6, 7 or 8 atoms, right, not more than that. And also they are very reactive, so not stable in nature. But if you are talking about the carbon, then carbon-carbon bond is very strong because they prepare covalent bond. And because the covalent bond between the carbon-carbon atom is very strong, that's why they are also stable in nature. So this is the one point we have discussed, that why carbon possessing the versatile nature. Now let's we discuss about the second point. The second point is that due to the 4 valency of the carbon atom, it is able, means carbon atom is able to bond with other elements like oxygen, hydrogen, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. And because of that reason, they are form bond with the other elements also. They are possessing the compound which possessing the specific properties, and that specific properties depend on the compound or depend on the element which is attached or which is bonded with the carbon atom. Suppose the carbon atom is bonded with the oxygen, then they will showing a particular kind of property. Exactly same way with nitrogen, also showing a different kind of property. So because of that reason, carbon able to form a varieties of compound which possessing the specific kind of properties. One more thing, that the size of the carbon atom is very small. Because of that reason, the protons possessed at the center or at the nucleus, in the nucleus of the carbon atom, are strongly attached or are able to strongly attract electrons towards itself. And because of this reason, they are very stable in nature. So in short, we can say that the due to small size, it will have the greater stability. And because of these two factors, the carbon possessing the versatile nature, so that we have discussed. Now let's we talk about the another topic in this chapter, that is 4.2.1, saturated and unsaturated carbon compound. Now what is the meaning of saturated and unsaturated carbon compound? So first of all, let's we see the definition, and then we will go through the examples. So if you are going to define the saturated carbon compound, it means carbon compound which possessing only single covalent bond. Then that kind of compound is called the saturated carbon compound. But if any of the carbon compound containing double or a triple bond, then that kind of carbon compound is considered as a unsaturated carbon compound. So let's we talk about, or let's we take the example of the saturated carbon compound. So the example is alkane. Now alkane having a single covalent bond between the carbon atom, there will be no presence of the double bond or a triple bond. Then this kind of alkane compound is a saturated alkane compound having only a single bond, right? sorry, here not bond, but it is single bond. Then we are having the example, like you can take two carbon atom having a single bond, then here three carbon atom having a single bond, right? Now next is alkene. Alkene means what? See, here I have highlighted something. If there is a single bond between the carbon compound and there is not presence of a double bond or a triple bond, then it will have in the suffix, that is ANE. Suffix means the letter which is added to the last of the compound. So that is ANE. It means if the single bond is there in the carbon compound, then they are called the alkene, which having the suffix ANE. These are all the things we are going to see in our next topic, that is the nomenclature of carbon compound. Okay. Now, unsaturated carbon compound we are talking about. So let's take the example, unsaturated carbon compound is alkene. Here suffix is ENE. When there is a presence of double bond, then they are known as the alkene and having the suffix ENE. And also, if any of the carbon compound having a triple bond, then they are having the suffix is YNE and they are called alkyne. These both are, alkene and alkyne, both are considered as a unsaturated carbon compound. Why? Because alkene and alkyne both possessing double bond or a triple bond, and because of that reason, as per the definition of unsaturated carbon compound, if either it is possessing a double bond, triple bond or both, then they are considered as the unsaturated carbon compound. So if you are going to take the example of alkene, so here you can see two carbon atom is there having a double bond in between them. So if you are representing this structure in form of electron dotted structure, then here you can see the 4 electron of one carbon atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 electron of another carbon atom, how they are bonded. So here the 2 carbon atoms sharing their 2 electrons each, and because of that reason they are forming here a double bond, and as they are forming a double bond, they are considering as a alkene. If you take the example of alkyne, then alkyne will have the triple bond. So here the example of alkyne, as you can see here, the carbon having a 4 electrons each, and here they are sharing their 3 electrons, and because of that reason they are preparing the triple bond, and that's why they are considering as the alkyne compound. In homologous series we are going to see that what is the alkane and what is the alkane compound and what is its series, that we are going to see in our next topic. But here basically, in short, you must have the idea that if you are talking about the saturated carbon compound, then the carbon compound which possessing only single bonds, and if you are talking about the unsaturated carbon compound, then the carbon compound either possessing double bond or triple bond or both, right? So here in this video we have seen why carbon possessing the versatile nature and what is a saturated and unsaturated carbon compound. In our next video, we are going to see the types of carbon compound, that is the long chain, branch chain, cyclic chain, etc. So till that, stay safe, stay at your home, and thank you, viewers.